We jamming, my people. I'm just having a good time, you know. It's a brand new week. We're in the mood to party. We're in the mood to entertain you. Since I got a lot of music to play for you. In fact, 2 hours is not even enough for this show for you. Yeah. How long can you play in a set?
6 hours.
6 hours?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's go 8.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
I think I can also MC like at least 4 hours. I can do MCing for 4 hours, yeah. We have the bloggers in the house. We have Josh Ruby. We have Susie Cosmas. So we're only talking about what has been, you know, going out or happening here and there when it comes to your celebrities and show business in Uganda and maybe abroad. In case you just joined us, this is 5 to 7. We do this from Monday to Friday, courtesy of Lucky 3. We want to thank you, Lucky 3, for powering this show. And it's about that time we talk about some of the things that have been trending online. Let's go on strictly on Twitter, yeah? Now, looking at the Twitter trends, the hashtag that is the number one is the word arrogancy. And I'm like, whoa, this is a random word that doesn't even mean anything. Josh, why is the word arrogance trending on Twitter? That's number one.
Twitter trends, Uganda. Every day there's not new words. Words we've seen being used, but because of certain situations.
Yeah.
Now, arrogance, over the weekend there was too much rugby being played. Mm-hmm. Locally and internationally, Uganda is actually in the sevens challenge. No, it was knocked out,
but
it was there, it was playing. So, arrogance was used mainly for, it came up in the rugby terms, like teams playing with arrogance and blah, blah, blah.
So, if Uganda still, really, Uganda was kicked out?
Yeah, it was kicked out of the sevens challenge.
Wow.
In Uruguay. So, we are no longer there.
And on number two, I see Entebbe. Why is Entebbe training? Is it because now you know our Uganda Airlines can now fly to Juba, Bujumbura, Dar es Salaam, Kilimanjaro, Mogadishu, Nairobi, and Mombasa?
Most probably, yeah. That should be. And I think sometimes it's not what's trending because of an event. Sometimes they hire influencers. Something like now that those new flights, they could have had influencers come up with those trades. Yeah, just to make noise.
Would you rather, but anyway, let me ask, would you prefer you using Uganda Airlines when you're going to any of these places like Mogadishu, whatever?
It's Mogadishu, so why not? It's the furthest Uganda Airlines can go is the furthest I can go with it. So, no problem with it.
And then lastly, number three, when it comes to trends, I see Uganda. One of the things that, you know, made the hashtag Uganda trend was, you know, we had Harvest Money Expo happening at Namboli from Friday to Sunday yesterday. And so many people flew in, you know, to come and be part of it. Have you attended Harvest Money Expo before, by the way? You should, really.
No, I but sinatuka.
Harvest Money Expo. Sibia kuzanya sewe. It is unexposable.
No, I see the information.
Yeah.
People come and they say, the people win, don't they win?
Not Lucky 3. This is
not Lucky 3. But people win in the expo.
Anyway, they do. And you know, it's a training that I also recommend, sister, to go next time Harvest Money Expo is happening. You were there for music.
Yeah.
If you were there,
it is not.
We don't want. Are we talking about farming? You know, looking at piggery, hot culture, and all that. Yeah, that is where also I learned my skills of, you know, having, you know, my farm in the village. Yeah.
What does the farm have?
Your farm.
My farm has farming. It has piggery. So we're doing pigs, we're doing in Kolobo Mew. I have pigs, I have rabbits.
And,
because of Harvest Money Expo. And away from that, let's come back, you know, to us being the show business here. And before we do that, let me also check on YouTube what the songs that have been trending as well here. I see Eddie Kenzo's Twaya Girl is still on number one when it comes to trends on Twitter, rather on YouTube. Then Shiba and Fifa Maker's song still now has joined, you know, the trends on YouTube, topping the charts at number two, as one of the trendiest songs happening on videos. Then Rema Namakula Still Clear is now number three. And looking at number four, we still have Sauti Sol, Susanna, trending on YouTube. And then finally, Nekwatako, which has over 297,000 views in 4 weeks. Mm. Well, it's a good start for Uganda. We're getting there when it comes to social media.
Rema and Kenzo are still dominating.
I'm telling you, they're really, this man, Rema and Kenzo, I don't know, we shall get rid of that, but in some type of way. And they are, you know, Rema, Kenzo.
I was looking at the YouTube trends. Trends not in terms of music. I'm talking about
information,
the most searched for artists in Uganda. Rema. Kenzo, Rema. When you look at the most searched for Kenzo, you see Toyagale, then you see Kalia.
Like, I know.
They just keep going on like that. And you might find like 3 Kenzo songs, then 2 Rema songs in a top 10 countdown. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I think their controversy and everything has turned out to be.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. Speaking about music still, you know, Chosen Blood on Friday released a new song with Spice Dana called Omuntu Wange. And, you know, what you know, beat me up was the video that, you know, him and Winnie Nwaji on a date. And I'm like, yo, guys, stop, you know, they're confusing us. They're just friends, blah, blah, blah.
Personally, I expected something like that.
Oh, they just want to make news.
News, no kubanti, it's a Valentine's Day, so people were with their lovers. So ne wini ya na the tula nanti na iya wale
sambo. Ne ali sorted, yeah?
Yeah, she posted her have nice flowers from.
Ah, nangi.
So the sala bimori bio.
Okakasa, they again up social media yangu.
That's Chosen Blood. Mumu lengira, ye ya gaya ne wini. Anti kade. So, who paid for the meals?
It's quite obvious. It's quite obvious. But again, I think the confusion came through. I think it's just Spice Diana. Yeah. So she bought her own flowers.
I'm sure she must have. But still with Chosen.
Yeah.
Maybe. Okay, Chosen bought the flowers. Winnie Nwaji bought the food. Oh man, amazing, amazing. I'm loving you guys.
Then it's going to get in the mix, but it was just a video shoot.
Yeah, it was. They just took you know, he posted a picture of Valentine, but you know, he didn't post it on Valentine. He posted a day before Valentine's for him and Spice Diana, the video shoot where he's putting on black, Spice and red, more of a Valentine kind of picture.
Yeah, it's because the song was going to be released
on Valentine, and also he couldn't post Spice Diana when, you know, he has to post this some type of way.
Yeah.
Wow, I'm loving this.
Think we can now rub out the doubts.
Yeah.
Because we've always been doubting. Are they? So I think now
Valentine chosen said it on some interview.
Yeah.
But he said he's like his best friend, vichy.
He said something.
I think now we know.
So anyway, Katulabe, it's in again a mass. So we're really winning chosen, but if you decide to, you know, really put it out there, I think it's a good cup. Would you recommend it?
It depends.
I'm about to depend. Salawo. Saga and water Salawo. Gamba, yes, they are a good couple. Oh, no, you don't buy them to be together.
I see Chosen as a very soft guy. Then I see Winnie as totally the opposite. So,
somebody's bagala soft guys.
Exactly. Bad boys want, you know, good girls. Good girls want bad boys.
Aren't a cool person.
Isn't it so?
Bagala soft.
Anyway, so, you're a good girl?
It's a good couple.
I'm sure, Susie, you like bad boys.
I don't like bad boys.
Okay, I'm not going to say it because I'll be going in another line of conversation, yeah? Let's talk about, you know, Honorable Nambose coming out to write a letter to Rema, you know, throwing off Chris Evans on stage, you know, showing the whole world his husband one time to another, blah, 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 blah. Tell me about it.
Honorable Betty Nambose wrote something long in that. Even when you're starting to read it, warning, this message is too long. She was criticizing Rema about what happened, quoting her on two things, starting on the Chris Evans saga, that Chris Evans was jokingly saying it, misinterpreting. And then secondly, he said about Rema.
Yeah, yeah.
Okujabawe mushobil.
Yeah, exactly. Ademu dualio. Mulaba mugamba ademu dualio.
Exactly.
It's too
Most people are judging. Depending on what happened.
Nambose is right. I agree with Nambose. Okay, for the meantime.
It's a natural get the right from the start.
But was it
Rema
really?
Has the right. Only Bawe.
But Bao, you've put Bao on stage, so then she's in the limelight, and you know what happens in the limelight.
You have to stop him from being in some interviews.
Well, no, my point is, you've introduced Dr. Hamza as your husband, but as well as a person who you want people to see.
Auntie Sima, why don't go ahead to interview my guy? Just like
okay, the good thing about putting your husband or boyfriend in the limelight if you're famous is that you know you get trending, you know you're everywhere, people talk about you, people do some this and that. But okay, the worst things come in when you know something goes bad and you break up. It has happened to me one time in some time back, like you know, and I learned my lesson. So Numbers is right, you know, the more we're seeing Sebunya on stage, you know, everywhere, making interviews here and there, always making appearance wherever she is, in some type of way, when things go wrong, we shall still realize, because we are, they will be all over us. I shall know when Rema has a good day, when they have not maybe had an argument, and when Rema is extremely happy, because now we literally know about how they operate and all this you get. So somehow it makes sense. I don't know if that letter made sense to you, so Cosmas. Do you agree with that?
I don't agree. I think
it didn't make sense.
We just have to learn to let people be. It's their life.
But they're not letting us be. they're all over in our faces, everywhere. Each time I look at Rema, I have to see.
I don't remember. It's like
Hamza.
It's
a couple, but I mean, he's a doctor, like Numbers says. Be in your hospital, be there, no problem.
And I'm sure they are still on our faces because now the wedding is coming.
They are still on us.
Yeah.
And that's
let's look at famous people like Oprah. How many times do you see Oprah's man? Very rare interviews.
This thing is quite different.
Okay,
it's
not different.
It's like she always prayed to God. I'm more mentally perfect.
Everyone prays to God.
Too much. It is too much.
You know, Sebunya is not a musician or an MC or a DJ. So, you know, the appearances that he's making, they're more than enough, honestly. Let's look at this lady. Who else? Let's say Beyonce and Jay, they're all artists, you know, it is okay.
Yeah, what they should do is just turn themselves to into premier, like, make money out of their image.
Yeah.
The thing is, Sebunya is a doctor, not a DJ.
No, I know.
So his appearances are too much.
Image is a big deal. They can make money out of it.
Otherwise, maybe he has to give up on the hospital life.
They're already a brand. They're already brand ambassadors. Two of them.
Yeah, this is what Rema always wanted. Even in her relationship with Eddie Kenzo, like she always hoped for someone who can be guaso lagako to the people na ina mlagako like that. And Kenzo wasn't in for that. Even the few times where he shared her photos, walabanganga, it's not really out there. So now that she's comfortable with it. If she wants us to be okay with it, then she should be okay with us not being okay with it. If you get what I mean, like if you're presenting your husband to the public, then let the public embrace him.
But you don't have to embrace him in a bad way.
There is no bad way.
When you're interviewing someone, sometimes a little girl will make the sense of you're choking, just like that.
But you're not a child. You're not a child. You can choose what to say. Bombuza interviewing
your
answer Sijina. I don't have to say.
So finally, was that letter that Honorable Numbers wrote necessary or not?
It wasn't. It wasn't necessary.
Josh.
It was. It's her opinion. So
yeah,
it is necessary to her. And
yeah.
Some of us.
She says.
Necessary.
That letter is so necessary, guys. He talked about something important. I'm telling you.
He talked about even the Amal situation.
Sebunya should go back to the hospital. At least let's meet him. We see him once in a while, not, you know, making appearances like, you know. Celine Dion was also married. He had whatever. But we could really, we only got to know his husband when he was dying. Oh, you get. We have this pastor woman who's extremely famous. This lady who's extremely famous, he has TV shows like across everywhere.
Joyce
Meyer. How many times do you see his husband, the husband coming on, you know? But they do, sea level. They should learn from the best you get. They make extremely lesser.
Let's come back here to Navio, who was recently married. How many times do you see his wife on social media?
Exactly. Even Mama Fina, how many times do you see her?
She also says it when I have been 3 years. through a lot.
Anyway, she's a young lady. Let's just keep that open, that she's a still young lady. She's not into...
Anyway, at the end of the day,
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to get back to the music. There's a lot of things to talk about here on Monday Bloggers. We come to discuss about the entertainment industry and how we feel about it. Don't feel bad if we get personal a little bit, because some of us share personal opinions. Yeah,
opinion.
And I'm sure everybody has their own opinion about whatever we're talking about. Let's get back to the music with CSA. We'll be back shortly to go on social media and read a couple of things here and there. Sampling me send a one year gone clear. If you not dancing, you never hear. CJ said, year after year, when you hear, watch you hold world up here over there. Over there.